Good day to the audience around the world. Today is Monday, August 17th, 2020, and it's now 11:30 p.m. in Taiwan. I'm Fiona Zhang Xinfeng. Welcome to the weekly news of the World New Religion, Taiwan Wei Xin Sheng Jiao at Weixin TV Station. Starting for today is Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan's footprint. Under Wang Chan Lao Su's holy revelation, from August 8th to 19th, Chanjishan Wei Xin Sheng Jiao is holding the Guanyin Bodhisattva's birthday celebration ritual, as well as the celebration of Wang Chan Lao Su's 38th year radiant arrival at the heavy altar of headquarters Xianfo's temple. 38 years ago, on the day of Guanyin Bodhisattva's birthday, Wang Chan Lao Su's holy spirit came to Grand Master Hun Yuan Chan Shi and united with him. Since then, Grand Master Hun Yuan Chan Shi started his religious career on propagating Yi Jing Feng Shui and religion to uphold the great wishes of world peace. This time, this ritual is the important one that Grand Master Hun Yuan Chan Shi and all virtuous fellows praying for subsiding the COVID-19 with their 38 years of marriage. Let's pray together for the betterment of the world, the termination of pandemics, and great harvest around the globe.
To pray for the world away from disasters and epidemics, Chanjishan Hui Xin Sheng Jiao held the birthday of Guanyin Bodhisattva and the 38th benediction ritual for sincerely inviting Wang Chan Lao Zu to randomly arrive at Wei Xin Sheng Jiao Main Hall and disaster elimination ritual. The ritual sincerely invited 33 heavenly kings from the South Heaven descend to the mundane world for disaster elimination and grievances resolving. 5 props and flowers were offered to worship evil and disaster spirits from 24 directions and 3 realms. From June 19th to July 1st on lunar calendar, there were 12 days to chant Wang Chan Lao Zu profound scripture, Guigu Immortal Master Heavenly Virtue scripture, Cultivation and Enlightenment Scripture of Hun Yuan, the Guanyin Bodhisattva Universal Gate Sutra, and so on, to worship the spirits from the 3 realms and the 10 Dharma directions. We hope the credits from chanted scriptures can attain the spiritual peace, societal harmony, and world peace. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi instructed that
消灾化解的法会法仪，我们已经进入第七坛，第六坛，我们所进行的、所祈祷的是人和、人和。人世间的灾难，都是从人和而引起的。人没有办法人和。要用奸诈、狡计来伤害人类的生命和伤人的心的时候，到最后来只有天意来惩罚众生，所以我们谨遵天法旨，本着为国修道、为人类来祈福，而在庚子年的当下，6月19日，恭祝观世音菩萨的圣诞及王禅老祖光降，娑婆世界台湾净土38周年的华喜之日。深谈由维新贤士同修和会大众来恭送归古现实天德经及维新圣教33经，总共数量务必要2350万部的功德。到当下已经有2260多万部，这些经宝的功德天 是在祈祷啊，玉皇大帝提供龙天护法、上帝阿拉、诸佛菩萨啊，明我唯心弟子所求，天恩永续，天灾永续。所以在昨天已经进入第六坛圆满和人和啊，人和的视线就从最近美国卫生部长和日本前首相啊两位啊人上人都一起乘专机来到台湾，这个是人和的最高境界的视线，这是天意，也不是凑巧啊！所以我们感恩观世音菩萨，感恩王禅老祖的慈悲啊！用这个演化来肯定大家所求，所以我们这一个祈福的法会啊，是为整个世界、为人类的平安而修。
Grand Master Hu Yuan Chan Shi stated that the pandemic outbreak was an demonstration from the will of the heaven. The purpose was to remind the public what we should always keep in mind to make human harmonious happen.Grand Master Hu Yuan Chan Shi not only showed appreciation to Wei Xing versus fellows, but also reminded people to keep chanting scriptures to fulfill our expectation. Wei Xing News Headquarters, Changjishan Shenfosi Temple.
These changes between Wei Xing Shenjiao and international religious organizations are built upon the passion and dedication of countless virtuous fellows.Today, overcoming the barriers of age, nationality, language, ethnicity, and culture, we have been propagating the magnificent Dharma and our religious ideals featuring Yi Jing Feng Shui to the world. In August, I just led the youth of Wei Xing Shenjiao to participate in Japan's Omotokyo Youth Online Meeting. In the face of a changing and complicated international landscape,We convey the mercy and love of Wang Chan Lao Zu. We wish harmony and safety to all of the worlds. In recent years, in order to link up with the world, the Center for Religious Affairs of Wei Xing Shenjiao acts actively in promoting the exchange with international communities, with the fundamental purpose of propagating Yi Jing Feng Shui to the world for the sake of world peace.We have developed the East Asian New Religion Association to pursue a peaceful world under the cooperation with different countries. Although the strict international transportation regulation has been implemented in response to COVID-19, the Center for Religious Affairs still carries on the global exchange by cyber meetings and internets. We also get the greeting emails from Australia,America, Italy, Japan, Korea, and Vietnam, in which praising Taiwan model in tackling the pandemic. On August 7th, the Iluha Online Youth Festival of Japan's Omotokyo invited Wei Xing Shenjiao youth to participate in and to express their wishes to the world through writing on the papers.The Iluha Youth Festival is an annual event held by Jinlui Aisankai of Omotokyo, which gathered with hundreds of international youth exchanging their ideals of making a peaceful world. By doing this kind of edification and interaction, Omotokyo values young people's opinions and shows respect to their futures. The Iluha Festival was scheduled to be held in Japan,But then it had been changed into an online festival due to the outbreak of COVID-19. Omotokyo edits the wishing photos of the young people from different countries in a memorial video. With this video, the international youth can exchange with each other and spread optimistic energies to the world. The representative youth from Weixin Shenjiao are Wang Zilin from Tainan Branch Temple, Shi Jiaxiang from Douliu Branch Temple, Hong Yonglin from Taichung Branch Temple, Zhang Xiuxian from Zhongshan Classroom, and Zhang Shunhui from Osaka Branch Temple in Japan. They are delighted to join this event. Weixin News, Taichung.
Take a break. We will come back soon.
维新电视台各时段优质节目，
For this week's Yijing Feng Shui Education, students of Architectural Design and Feng Shui Summer Program for college students embarked on an outdoor education on August 7th. Let's take a look.
In the 2020 Architectural Design and Feng Shui Summer Program for college students on August 7th, under the leadership of Master Yuan Quan, the head teacher, the students started outdoor teaching. Visited Weixin Shenjiao headquarters, Shanji Shanxian Fosi Temple, and the Wood Factory, learned various roles of Feng Shui and architectural design. The group first came to Weixin Shenjiao headquarters, Shanji Shanxian Fosi Temple. As soon as everybody entered the mountain gate, Master Yuan Quan began to explain the construction of the mountain gate, including the upside mountain, the design of the gate, and the rules of opening the gate, the elements of feng shui in it, and etc., and what should be known about temple architectural design. Master Yuan Quan led the students to the mountain and explained along the way, such as the design of entering and extending the dragon ladder, and the religious meaning hidden in it, the construction design of the gate, and the use method of Wengong ruler. The students also took the Wengong ruler to measure the gate on the spot and recorded notes and took photos and carefully recalled the knowledge of feng shui architecture. Afterwards, Master Yuan Quan led all the students to worship Wangshan Laozu, praying for blessing to protect the safety of the teaching process, and then introduced the feng shui of Weixin Main Hall and the landscape layout in front of it. Following the visit to the ultimate bliss hall overlooking the opposite mountain and the mountain of the tiger side and the dragon side around the Shenfosi Temple, under the introduction of Master Yuan Quan, the students fully understood the geographical environment of Shenfosi Temple. Following Master Yuan Quan to go deep into Shenfosi Temple to explore other landscape architectures, listening to Master Yuan Quan's professional architectural design and feng shui explanations, students are immersed in the knowledge of the I Ching and feng shui, religion and architecture, focusing on the study of the wondrous Dharma and admiring the beauty of the temple architecture. After visiting the Shenfosi Temple in the afternoon, Master Yuan Quan led students to the Wood Furniture Company in Tanzi District, Taichung, and visited the factory buildings. Master Yuan Quan from the Royal Taiwanese Business People Services Association explained to the students the layout plan for the construction of this wood company and the feng shui principles that it followed. Master Yuan Quan also explained that good feng shui is 30% for nature and 70% of how people make it, so that to assist the company's factory operations. In addition, feng shui rules are used to avoid the influence of the negative energy, so as to resolve the influence of the external environment's negative energy on the operation of the factory. The students are very serious about learning and recording, hoping to use the knowledge in future professional design to benefit the residents. Weixin News at Weixin Shenjiao College.
Coming up next is our latest news about the Dharma service. Changjishan Weixin Shenjiao Su'ao Branch Temple launched its anniversary benediction ritual, in which the classic scriptures were recited for the benediction and safety of the neighborhood.
On August 8th, Changjishan Weixin Shenjia Sua Branch Temple held the 12th anniversary disaster elimination and benediction ritual and performed the rites of purifying the boundaries for the Dharma session and soul summoning, presided by Master Yuan Heng of the Weixin Shenjia Chanting College. The Sua Branch Temple host, Master Yuan Zhi, led all the virtuous fellows and the public, sincerely invited Wang Chan Lao Zhu and all Buddhas to enter the mandala. They also summoned the ancestral spirits in the local district of Sua Branch Temple and spirits from the three realms and the 10 Dharma directions to listen to the chanting and wondrous Dharma, receiving the offering in the ritual. Virtuous fellows of the Sua Branch Temple have dedicated themselves to supporting the ritual, arranging the mandala, setting up the offering table, and following the chanting masters, reciting scriptures to transfer the merits to the spirits of the Dharma realm. Sua Branch Temple has also prepared abundant offering tables and gold and silver papers to make an offering to the 10 directions of the Dharma realm. They pray for the blessings of the Buddhas, Bodhisattvas, and holy deities for the underworld and human world and blessings all living beings with peace and prosperity, the safety of the country and the people, permanent elimination of natural disasters and epidemics, and world peace. On the afternoon of August 9, after making an offer of sweet stew to the spirits of the Dharma realm, all virtuous fellows and volunteers helped to clean up the offering table and mandala, so that the surrounding areas of the branch temple could quickly return to normal. Master Yuan Zhi thanked the virtuous fellows for their hard work and sent souvenirs to thank them for their help. The ritual was successful. Weixin News, Sua Branch Temple.
Take a break. We will come back soon. Now it's time for Weixin Shenjia feature story. We're sharing with you the utilization of Yi Jing Feng Shui in our daily lives and how to present the modernity, pragmatism, and importance of Yi Jing Feng Shui. Let's watch it together. Ladies and gentlemen, Amitofo. Welcome for watching Weixin Shenjia feature story. Grandmaster Hunyuan Chan Shi always reminds us that life is precious. Not all the sentient beings have the opportunities to reincarnate into human. Some beings waited for 1,000 years until incarnation, and some even couldn't have a chance to have a new life. So we should treasure our human life and body. Following is a short story regarding the importance of the usage of feng shui in our living environment. Mr. Li is a fellow based in Japan a few years ago. He came to Xianfo's temple to worship Wang Chan Lao Zhu, praying for having a grandson. According to the Yi Jing revelation from Wang Chan Lao Zhu, the son of Mr. Li is not supposed to have offspring when it was analyzed in fatalistic way. However, since Li's family participated in lots of charitable works, it was not that difficult to receive an extra mercy for having a grandson. Grandmaster Hunyuan Chan Shi further explored about Mr. Li. Mr. Li got a decent job. The whole family is hardworking and enthusiastic in charity. Grandmaster Hunyuan Chan Shi guessed the reason of Mr. Li not having grandson yet was due to inappropriate feng shui arrangement at home. Then, Mr. Li drafted both infrastructure and external structure of his house immediately and showed the photos of his house to Grandmaster Hunyuan Chan Shi. Grandmaster Hunyuan Chan Shi realized there was a depression with over 10 feet deep at Dragon Side. When he investigated the furniture inside, he found there was a processing machine running with loud noise at the tiger's side. This phenomenon is exactly the hexagram of Zheng Wei Lei, which means thunder represented by Zheng. Zheng refers to shaking in Chinese. The dragon's side represents Yang. However, the Yang was completely shadowed by Yin,
which was the tiger side with loud noise and shaking. Now offspring without dragon and alerting tiger would harm offspring are the two taboos in feng shui. Mr. Li breached both of that. No wonder his grandson never come. Grandmaster Hun Yuanchan Shi suggested Mr. Li to rearrange the machine to the left-hand side instead of right-hand side so that when it was running, the air energy and water energy appeared at dragon side for generating auspicious energy. In that way, the situation that Mr. Li had been worried about would be improved. A year passed. Grandmaster Hun Yuanchan Shi received a souvenir of snake from Japan with a thank you card. Mr. Li mentioned in the card that he was amazed by the effectiveness of Chinese feng shui. There was a good news. When Mr. Li returned to Japan last year, then he followed the instruction from Grandmaster Hun Yuanchan Shi to move the machine to the left-hand side. After doing so, his daughter-in-law was pregnant soon and gave birth to a baby successfully. Half a year later, Mr. Li brought a little baby with his family to Xianfo's temple to express gratitude towards Wangchan Laozu. The baby entered the temple and showed his curiosity about the surrounding environment, laughing delightfully. Grandmaster Hun Yuanchan Shi felt that the baby is intelligent, then held him in arms and told the baby that, "Sweet baby, your life was given thanks to your grandpa praying wholeheartedly. You should treasure this rare opportunity for being human in the modern world." The baby looked at Grandmaster Hun Yuanchan Shi innocently and smiled. Life is precious, and it's not easy for every sentient being to have the opportunity to reincarnate into human. We should treasure our life and perform self-cultivation profoundly. We are here to encourage each other and hope that all of you are filled with the joy of Dharma. Thanks for your watching. Weixin Shenjiao Branch Temples have been preparing offerings and delicacies for the Guanyin Bodhisattva's birthday celebration on the 19th day of the 6th month of the Chinese calendar. Let's take a look at the footage coming from each branch temple.
Guanyin Bodhisattva Enlightenment Day is on 8th of August, which is on the same day on 19th of June of lunar calendar. On that day, Changjishan Weixin Shenjiao Branch Temples held ritual to celebrate. They prepare fire, vegetarian, longevity peach and noodle for Dharma offering. They celebrated the birthday of Guanyin Bodhisattva. Taipei Da'an Temple performs soul summoning in spirit-bearing rite on 5th of August. Preparation of birthday and anniversary celebration ritual also started on that day. College students of summer program and worship fellows helped decorate the altar. It was a good chance for them to experience the religious ritual and sympathy for others. Da'an Temple invited eminent monk to hold the altar commencement, chanting Sharangama Mantra, Diamond Repentance Sutra, and 88 Buddha's Repentance Sutra. On 8th of August, heaven offering rite was held in the morning and yoga flaming mouth rite completed in the afternoon. Other branch temples also held birthday celebration ritual in the morning on 8th of August. They presented flower and fruit, longevity peach and noodle. Abbots and chanting masters lead the fellows to chant Wangchan Laozu profound scripture, the heavenly virtue scripture of immortal master Gui Gu, and the universal gate sutra on Guanyin Bodhisattva. They offer Dharma to 10 directions of Dharma rain berries. They express the gratitude for the sympathy of Guanyin and Wangchan Laozu. Their sympathy motivated Weixin Shenjiao to save all creatures and pray for disaster elimination. Weixin TV Integrated Reports.
Thank you for tuning in today. In the face of the pandemic, Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chanshi has told us that Taiwan should not keep our happiness only to ourselves and enjoy the current safety alone. We should share and help people around the globe. Through cautious epidemic prevention measures, we are able to keep it together and live in our new norms.As we recite the heavenly virtue scripture of immortal master Gui Gu, the ideals of making the Mother Earth a safe place and spreading our happiness to every global citizen are aspired. Chanjishan Weixin Shenjiao is fulfilling our religious practice, eliminating disasters, meanwhile, continue praying for Taiwan and the world.We will be back with more news updates about Chanjishan Weixin Shenjiao. Please stay tuned at 11:30 p.m. on every Monday and 11:30 a.m. and 4 o'clock p.m. on every Tuesday on Weixin TV. May the plague end and the coming of a harmonious world. See you next week.